Hi everyone, my name is Seth, Seth Vixen. I hope you're all having a fantastic day today because my days have been nothing but up and down, and it is time to finally come back to YouTube. And I just want to talk to you guys a little bit today about what's been going on in my life. Where the heck did I go? Because I have not posted in nearly, 6 weeks, something like that. Haven't posted in a while. I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of an update about what's been going on in my life. Some things that I was planning for 2022. What kind of derailed from YouTube. And just want to talk to you guys and, talk to my fans. See what's going on. See what's going on in their lives. See what's going on in my life. And we will, that's what we're going to do. That's what we're going to talk about today. Just, where the heck did Seth Vixen go? And that's what we're going to do. But first, it is the holidays. We're going to put on this little Santa hat. Because, why not? Oh, by the way, check out my really cool Rudolph Christmas sweater. I got it from a really good friend of mine that I'm going to mention in this video. But so, let's begin this video about where I have been. One of the first events that has happened since my last YouTube video was that, if you guys can tell from this background, this is a new place. I actually ended up moving in with one of my best friends. We ended up moving in together because there was a situation with my last house where my landlord ended up selling the property, so there wasn't much that I could do, unfortunately. She ended up selling the house. I was stressed out. I was freaking out because I've never had something like that happen to me before. So that was a very, very stressful couple weeks. I was not a fan of the realtor. She was very, very difficult to work with. She was very mean at points in time, but I ended up moving in with one of my best friends, and it's been pretty good so far. For those of you that have even the slightest bit of moving experience, you guys know it's very stressful. It's very time consuming. You gotta pull everything out of your house, end up cleaning the house, and all that stuff. That was a very, very stressful, 6 weeks prior. And during the moving process, I actually had another YouTube video planned that we will talk about later in this video. But so that's how that started and what kind of began my derailment of YouTube for the time being. And no joke, 3 days later, probably one of the darker moments of 2021 was that my grandma sadly passed. I got an emergency phone call from my mom. My work gave me an emergency phone call, told me what happened. So I ended up driving back home about 12 hours just to at least pay my respects to my grandma. So she sadly passed. I was home for about a week where I did nothing furry related whatsoever. Sadly, we knew it was coming. I was not too prepared for it. I mean, you're not really ever prepared for the death of a relative, which, I mean, it's hard. It was a hard couple days, but we powered through. I don't think that's something that you really expect as soon as you move in, then you get a call saying that one of your relatives passed away. But I'm doing okay now with it. It is what it is, and I'm happy that she's just not suffering anymore. So I came home, paid my respects to my grandma, and as soon as I came back, I had my very, very first furry convention. The first one that I've ever been to was Bewhiskered 2021. Like I said, it was my very, very first convention. I was so stoked for it. I'm gonna put a couple of pictures in the corners of the YouTube video just to show you guys the fun I had. That is also when I got my full suit. So my TikToks now, you pretty much always see me in my full suits. I literally got that suit like the day of the convention, and I was nervous throughout the whole in-transit process and it actually getting to me and all that stuff. And that was so much fun. I got to meet so many different people. I got to meet so many different furs. Made a couple friends along the way. But actually going to a convention and meeting some people, and some of the people on top of it actually knew who I was from TikTok. So that was something I've never experienced before. people actually coming up to me, recognizing who I am. And I was like, oh my God, like this is an amazing feeling. This is an amazing thing. And I didn't expect it. So if you were at the Whisker 2021, I want to thank you guys so much for actually watching my content, for coming up to me, saying thank you, you know, and just taking a picture. You know, that was one of the biggest things that I actually really loved about the Whisker. So that was my very first convention. Like I said, I'm going to put some pictures up during this video, just to, you know, give you guys a little bit of an idea. And I cannot wait to do it next year. So the day after Be Whiskered, I ended up taking a small vacation to see a very special someone. You have seen him in some of my TikToks. I went to go see Sharpie Fox. He's one of the greatest furs I have ever met in my life, and I'm so happy that he is with me. I'm so happy that I got to interact with him, be with him for that week. And I just had an overall fun time chilling out with him. We went to the lake, we shot a couple TikToks, had a couple parties, and it was just an overall fun time spending it with Sharpie Fox. So after I went to go see Sharpie, I ended up having Thanksgiving at my place. We brought our friends over with myself, Biscuit, Sharnix, you've seen her in a couple of my TikToks, as well as a new friend that I met at Be Whiskered, being Cassette Tape. We had fun Thanksgiving. For our Thanksgiving, we didn't have turkey, we didn't have mashed potatoes or corn. We actually ended up getting two McDonald's dinner boxes, and that was our Thanksgiving. But it didn't matter because, you know, as the old saying goes, it doesn't matter the holiday as long as you're around friends and family. And I am a true believer in that, because that was one of the best Thanksgivings I have ever had in my life with some of my best friends. And I do want to thank them so much for making Thanksgiving 2021 one of my favorite Thanksgivings that I will always remember for the times to come. But so after Thanksgiving, we get into one of the most recent events of my life. 2 days after Thanksgiving, I started having a couple of stomach pains, and I thought that it was just a stomach bug or something I ate, something along those lines. Fast forward 2 days later, and those stomach pains still have not subsided. So I check into the ER, they take my blood pressure, they take my blood and all that stuff. They ended up doing a CT scan, only to find out that I needed emergency surgery on my appendix. So that is not what I was expecting for the last week of November, first week of December, to get emergency surgery on my appendix. So they had to take that out. I recovered in the hospital for about a day or two, and I've just been sitting at home recovering from this surgery. And it's been so miserable for me, because I'm not one to actually just sit around and do nothing. And sometimes it was even hard to suit and do videos. So that's kind of where my mental state has been at. Granted, it was a fast surgery, I should be back next week, but it was still something that was not on my bucket list of things to do for this year. But I'm happy that I'm here, I'm happy that I'm alive. I've been told some horror stories on people who don't get their appendix checked out, and people who sadly pass away from it. But we caught it at a very, very early stage, and we were able to remove it. But so now we fast forward to today. Like I said, I am still recovering from my emergency appendix surgery. Christmas is coming up, as well as New Year's, and I want to give you guys a couple things to look forward to in 2022. So one of the first videos that I'm going to be planning for 2022 are my top 8 furry TikTokers. Nice. I have talked to multiple furries about getting this video together. They have all agreed to it. It was one of the videos that I mentioned earlier that I was going to do that I never got a chance to do because of the events that have been unfolding for the past 6 weeks. But I've got 8 furry TikTokers that are probably more than willing to be in this video. I also have another video that I was going to entitle Fox Transformation. You guys will see that in 2022. I'm going to be posting more videos with my best friend Sharnix, as well as Sharpie the Fox. You guys will get more Sharnix and more Sharpie with myself as well as Biscuit and Cassette Tape. We are planning a lot of different things coming up, as far as videos and TikToks are concerned. So we got that going for us as well. So another thing that we got planned for 2022 is that I got asked to do a podcast with my friend Casey, where we just talk about furry things, we talk about things going on inside the fandom, and get everything you could think of in a regularly scheduled furry podcast. So that's gonna be really exciting. Keep your eyes out for that. I will keep you guys updated on that as well as Casey will. And then some conventions that I plan on doing in 2022. I am already scheduled to go to BRFF, the Blue Ridge Fur Fest, in March of 2022. I am planning a lot more conventions as the time goes on. A lot of it is just going to be money and getting time off of work. But so I am planning more than one convention this year, and I cannot be more excited to meet you guys. I cannot be more excited to actually go see some friends that I haven't seen since we whiskered. So that's it for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed that video, and I missed you guys so much, and I am so happy to finally be back in the chair, finally happy to give you guys some good furry content and just overall saying hi to you guys and interacting with you guys. 2022 is going to be a great year for us. It's going to be a great year for furries. I cannot wait to see what 2022 has in store for us. Be sure to follow me on TikTok. If you like this video, give this video a like, and remember, stay furry, stay positive, and I will see you guys next year. Everyone have a very, very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Bye!